Fontus uses a solar panel and condenser attached to a bike to convert water vapor from the air into a bottle of drinking water. And Cellufoam is a wood-based, renewable, biodegradable, shock-absorbing, potential future alternative to styrofoam. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. Cota wants to charge every device within 30 feet wirelessly. In development since 2001, the transmitter, which is made up of thousands of tiny antennas angled slightly different from one another, receives RF pings from a microchip receiver embedded on your device and reflects them back with an increased power level of up to 1 watt. And the process is repeated 100 times per second. The charge speed is 1/5 to 1/3 of USB, but it continuously charges untethered until the battery is full, whether it's in your hand, pocket, or on the table. But the concept isn't just for phones. It's for wireless door locks, smoke detectors, remote controls, video game controllers, or electric toothbrushes. It'll be another 5 years before this becomes commercially available. A new smart pill seeks to measure the gas inside you. The impact of gas on health is poorly understood, in part because it's difficult to measure inside the gut. So the new gas pills detect hydrogen, methane, and carbon dioxide and wirelessly transfer the results to an app. Researchers from RMIT and Melbourne believe this could lead to a future of optimized diets customized for all individuals. In 1781, Benjamin Franklin actually proposed the study of farts. In an essay that was part science and part humor, Franklin cited the same problems, that internal gases were difficult to understand and measure. He hoped to find a drug that made farts smell like perfume. 235 years later, we may not have realized Franklin's dream of lavender flatulence, but we're on the path to understanding the effects of diet on gut disorders like IBS and Crohn's disease. FGF21 is a life-extending, immune-function-boosting hormone in mice. Researchers at the Yale School of Medicine found that increasing the levels of the hormone produced in the thymus gland led to a 40% lifespan extension. If, and this is a big if, that were to apply to humans someday, it would raise the average life expectancy from about 79 to over 110 years old. They do believe the implications for improving immune function in the elderly could help combat illnesses such as type 2 diabetes and cancer. Addibots are mobile 3D printing robots that could fill potholes. It was first tested by repairing skating cuts in ice by essentially printing ice, precisely depositing water kept just above freezing. For roads, the additive manufacturing robots will need to keep tar materials at a high temperature, so further research and development is currently underway. Spermbots. To help combat male infertility, researchers from Germany have developed magnetically driven microheliuses that go over the tail of sperm and act as motors. They've successfully driven sperm in the lab, but are still far from beginning human clinical trials for the cyborg sperm. Michigan Engineering is developing a full-page Braille display for the visually impaired. The pneumatic display uses bubbles driven by air or fluid, which is much cheaper than existing electronic displays that can cost up to $55,000. The challenge now is to fit all 5,000 to 10,000 physically controlled dots in a compact mobile space. The GyroGlove aims to control tremors in the hands of people with Parkinson's disease. A mechanical gyroscope on the back of the hand resists the hand movement caused by tremors by up to 90%. They hope to launch in the UK by the end of 2016, but first need to try to make it spin silently and remain balanced. VertiGo is a wall-climbing robot. The collaboration between Disney Research Zurich and ETH easily transitions from ground to wall by maximizing thrust and minimizing vehicle weight. It features two propellers for thrust and a carbon fiber base plate to minimize weight. Mostly, I just want one. Finally, here's Boston Dynamics' Atlas robot doing some household chores. I'm gonna leave you with FlyAbility, a drone with a spherical, freely rotating protective cage. And as always, thanks for watching.
keeping in touch by means of the amazing new Bell Boy is the Bell System's answer today for doctors, salesmen, delivery men, or anyone who must be available at all times in the fast-paced world of Century 21. When someone calls and you are out, you can be reached by dialing your Bell Boy code number. When you get a signal on the bellboy, you can go to a phone to call your office or home and get the message.